I've spent the last few months really diving deep in my research into the metaverse, so I finally wanted to make a video to walk you through exactly what the metaverse is and how you could benefit from it as well. In my research, a lot of videos and a lot of content that I consumed were so next level where I was super confused. I still couldn't figure out where to start. So hopefully with this video, I'm gonna simplify it enough that this could be your introduction into the metaverse, and then you could explain it to other people or share this video with them if this comes up. So in the simplest term, the metaverse is a virtual reality world. This is all on a computer basically, and it's all virtual. In the metaverse, you could do a ton of different things. You could interact with people, you could interact with objects, you could interact with buildings. Again, all in a virtual game. It's almost like playing a game of life inside of a computer. You could also own things inside of the metaverse. So for example, you could own a plot of land and build a virtual building on that land. You could also own digital assets in that world as well. Those are called NFTs, or non-fungible tokens. Now, I have a completely separate video dedicated to introduction to NFTs, so I won't go deeper about NFTs, but just to simplify, you could own property and you could own digital assets in the metaverse. So how do you actually enter the metaverse? How do you get into it? Where is this metaverse? How do I see it? How do I interact with these things? I'm gonna show you that exactly in this video, but before I do that, I have to explain to you the concept of metaverse, because it's just not one place. There is not just one metaverse. So if you think of our physical world, right, there is one planet. All of us live in this planet. Well, the metaverse is not quite like that, because there's a bunch of different metaverses. So I kind of think of it as multiple different planets. You get to choose which one you want to interact in. So there's a couple of ways to actually go inside of a metaverse. I'm going to show you here just on my computer. You could actually go to a website that takes you into one metaverse. You could also jump into a metaverse using a virtual reality headset. Now, this one is called Oculus Quest 2. Oculus has other headsets as well, and this one is owned by Meta Platform, otherwise known as Facebook. And this is basically a way to get into their metaverse, right? Where you could play their games, where you could use their software and their apps. But some of the other ones I'm gonna show you are not owned by Facebook or any company really. They are what is called decentralized platforms. And I'm gonna show you the most popular one and the second most popular one in a second. And that's really how I like to think about it. As far as a metaverse, some are going to be eventually owned by big corporations like the one Facebook has and the one Microsoft is putting together as well. So those are gonna be what a company owns, metaverses that a company owns. And then there are going to be decentralized metaverses. Those are metaverses that are on the blockchain that no single company owns. And another common question that comes up all the time is, well, why would I wanna spend any time in the metaverse? Why wouldn't I just do these things in the real world? Well, a lot of it comes down to convenience. In the metaverse, you could go from any location to another location just by teleporting. You just click on a location and you're all of a sudden there. You don't have to physically go to another place. And this is sort of how I think of 2020 and how Zoom became the way we all communicated via video. This is sort of the next level to that, right? Well, why would we have a Zoom call where we could go in person and see someone? Well, we couldn't do that. And that kind of normalized that whole process. And really, I think this virtual reality metaverse world kind of got a life from that experience we had in 2020 and beyond, where we just couldn't be physically at different locations, or maybe we didn't want to travel at all. So this is going to be the next level to that. And if I was to watch this video 15 years from today, I think it's going to be the norm. And I think we're going to spend the majority of our day in the metaverse and less time in the real world, just like this. Let me just show you the different types of metaverses that are available. There's this website, which is a marketplace for NFTs and virtual lands and all kinds of things like that, called OpenSea. If you go to OpenSea.io, you could press explore and you could see all kinds of different things. But for this video, I wanna show you this one called Virtual Worlds. You could go here and see all kinds of virtual worlds that are available. But an easier way to look at this, if you go on their stats and look at ranking, you could actually change the category here just to virtual worlds. So virtual worlds are basically the different metaverses, And these are all the ones that are going to be decentralized. All the ones that are going to show up here are not the ones owned by big companies like Facebook and Microsoft. I'm going to actually sort this by all time just to show you the biggest metaverses that are available. The most popular metaverse, the one I've been showing you here, is called Decentraland. I'm going to dive a bit deeper into Decentraland in a second. The second one is called Sandbox. You could sort this by latest as well to see what's trending at the time you're watching this video. But as you could see, these are just the top two, but as you go down, you could see a ton of different types of metaverses here, or virtual reality worlds. So if you decide to learn about any one of these, it's best to work yourself down this list. I'm gonna cover a couple in this video. So let's start here with Decentraland, and decentraland.org is the website for that, and you could learn more about it here. Basically, this is this entire virtual world where you could do all kinds of different things. You could even own your own land here, which is going to be my next video after this one, showing you how to buy land. But you could jump in right now on your computer. You don't need a VR headset. You could press start exploring, and you could play as a guest just to see what this world's all about. With Decentraland, you could build your own avatar or your virtual character. You could jump into the game and start exploring. You could chat or even use your microphone to interact with other people. You could also use the map to see all kinds of different things with an overview of what's around you. And you could just teleport to any one location or event in a second. You don't actually have to walk over to a place. A lot of times you could teleport to the next place you want to go to. Decentraland also has its own marketplace on their website where you could actually browse, and you could look at different things like NFTs that you could own, and you could show these off or wear these within the game. They also have land here that you could buy, so you could actually look at a big overview of the map, and you could buy any little parcel of land here in Decentraland. OpenSea also has a Decentraland collection here, where this works more like what an eBay platform, where you have a minimum bid and you could bid on land and then compete in a auction kind of format. And some have a buy it now as well, where you could go ahead and browse this platform for buying land there. And at first, this may just look like a low quality game to you, but I think as this gets more and more traction, people are going to start attending live events, concerts, they're going to have sporting events. There's going to be a whole bunch of virtual experiences that you could have without leaving your home. And I think once this headset and other headsets really take off, it's going to make this very immersive experience. Right now, again, watch my unboxing video of this, but the games within this Oculus Quest, which again, this is the Facebook one, are mind-blowing. But when I show it on the computer, they don't really do it justice because you need that virtual reality experience. Same thing when you enter a metaverse. It's really not gonna look great or really feel that immersive when you look at it on the computer. But once you jump in a VR world, really what it's designed to be, you're really going to be blown away, I think. The second biggest one of all time is called Sandbox. Let me jump into Sandbox. Now, the Sandbox actually has a lot of traction and has even people like Snoop Dogg doing concerts within that virtual world or that metaverse. And you could read more about it on their website, sandbox.game. And you could see some of the partners they have, including Atari, Hell's Kitchen, and more. And this is, again, very similar to Decentraland. It's completely decentralized. It's on the blockchain. It's not owned by a certain company. You could also explore the map as well on this game. And because the headsets, the better headsets that I've used personally, are owned by bigger companies, they're gonna be a little bit closed off. So maybe with this one right now, you could only explore the metaverse that Facebook allows you to explore, but they're gonna open it up, I think, to more and more, and more headsets are going to come out. But in the meantime, you could explore these things on the computer if you don't have a headset at all. And I should also mention, inside of each metaverse, they do have their own currency. For the case of Decentraland right here, their currency is called Mana, M-A-N-A. You could actually buy this coin on places where they sell virtual currency. So the virtual currency of Decentraland, which is Mana, can be used to buy all kinds of events, activities, and plots of land. Now, to buy Mana, you could use something like the US dollar, you could use a platform like Coinbase, and you could just convert your dollar to Mana. Again, this is not investing advice, but just do your own research if you want to learn more about these digital currencies and how they work. Now, these metaverses, they typically each have their own kind of a economy and their own currency. So Decentraland, Mana is the currency. Like in our world or in the country I live in, the US dollar is our currency, right? So it just depends on what metaverse you choose, and then you can figure out what currency they accept. Now, a lot of these currencies can be bought with your regular money. So I could buy with US dollars Mana and then use Mana to actually do things in the metaverse that I chose, Decentraland. So within that, I could actually buy things or buy events or buy land with Mana. I'll put a link below to this video where I show you exactly what this thing is and what it looks like. And if you want to buy your own, there's a link in that video as well. And in the following video, I want to show you how to buy land in the metaverse. So that's a way you could invest in the future if you think that's a way to go. Not a financial advice type of video, just kind of a how-to educational video on how to invest in assets. Make sure you watch my NFT videos if you want to get a deep dive on what NFTs are. And then I'm making videos on blockchain, Ethereum, Web3, all kinds of things related to this kind of a universe coming up in the next few weeks. Thanks so much for your time, and I will see you on the next video.